I feel that the ordinary peeling solution started the craze of chemical peels into the common people, and it reminds me of an episode from SEX and the City where Samantha burned her skin by chemical peels, but these peels are not like that, thank God. Hey my kitty cats, I'm your host Manvi, and today we are going to talk about exfoliation through chemical peels and how often can we use it and the skincare after using chemical peels. So today we are going to clear all of the confusion. Last week we talked about the exfoliation through your toners, glycolic acid based toners, and today we are going to talk about the chemical peels. So let's get started. If you haven't seen my video on glycolic acid based toners like Pixiglotonic, Dr. Shet Gulab and glycolic toner, then I highly suggest that you watch this video first and then continue with this, because both of these videos are interconnected. Now let's get started with the chemical exfoliation through chemical peels. There are two types of exfoliation, physical and chemical. Physical exfoliation involves the removal of dead skin cells manually, and these are like old school scrubs, and personally I do not like scrubs on my face because these form micro tears on your skin, which is not good in the long run. While chemical exfoliation removes the dead skin cells by dissolving the bond between the dead skin cells, which is loosely attached to your skin. So I have three peels with me. One is from Dr. Shet. This is the Basic Brightening Extra Gentle Daily Peel, and then I have the Ordinary AHA BHA Peeling Solution, very popular, and then we have the Dot & Key Hydro Peel. So today I'm gonna use the Dr. Shet Basic Brightening Extra Daily Gentle Peel. This is not supposed to be used daily, so I'm just gonna apply it on my the pump is not really good, as you have seen. So I'm just gonna apply it on my skin. I haven't used chemical peels in a week, so that's why I'm using it today. And I feel some texture on my skin, especially around my nose and whiteheads. So I'm gonna let it marinate for 10 minutes and then wash it off and use the chemical peels once in a week. I think that's enough, especially when you're using glycolic acid based toners in your everyday skincare routine. So make sure that you use once in a week and apply it for 10 minutes and then wash it off and use it in the nighttime preferably. And if you want to use it during daytime, make sure that you're not going outside. And if you're using it in the nighttime, make sure that you apply sunscreen in the next day before going out. So mainly there are three types of acid which are used in exfoliation. I'm telling you this because you should know which acid is for your skin types. Number one is AHAs, alpha hydroxy acids. These are also known as fruit acids because these come from fruits, but these can be synthetically produced. AHAs work on the surface level of your skin and they improve the texture of your skin, so it is for dry, normal and combination skin types. And AHAs have the ability to dissolve in water, so these work beautifully on the surface of your skin. Most commonly used AHAs are glycolic acid, mandelic acid, lactic acid, and glycolic acid is my personal favorite because it has a very small molecular size and it can penetrate deep into your skin and work on the deeper level of your skin. And it can also remove the texture on your skin, whiteheads, blackheads, and can shrink your pores and can instantly brighten up your skin. Dr. Shet peel is mainly made up of glycolic acid and lactic acid, AHAs, and that's why it is more mild and gentle on my skin, and I prefer Dr. Shet peel any day. So BHAs are oil soluble and they can penetrate into your pores and unclog them and also remove the excess sebum, which causes acne. And this is why salicylic acid is used in so many skincare products, which prevents acne and in the treatment of acne. Now let's talk about third type of acid, that is PHA, polyhydroxy acid. These are very similar to AHAs in terms of functionality, but these are larger in size, so these cannot penetrate deep into your skin, so these are less irritating for your skin. So these can be used by extremely sensitive skin types and people with eczema and rosacea. So I don't have any peeling solution which has PHA in it, but I know that Ordinary has a PHA peeling solution, so you can use that one. So now you know why BHAs are for oily and acne prone skin types. I have two peels for you which has AHA and BHA, and one is the Hydro Peel from Dot & Key and the Ordinary Peeling Solution. I will talk about both of these peels after I wash off my face because 10 minutes are over and I'm supposed to wash off my face, and we will also do the skincare after this peeling solution. So I'll be back. And ta-da, this is how my skin looks like after using chemical peels. It's clean and glowy, and you can see it has brightened up. So now we will do the skincare routine after using chemical peels, and we will skip the glycolic acid based toners today if you use glycolic acid based toners in your everyday skincare routine, because you might over exfoliate. So instead of using a glycolic acid based toner, we will use rose water toner on my face, and I'm gonna use the Karma Ayurveda rose water. This is the amazing, most amazing rose water toner, and it's so soothing on my skin, and it has never irritated my skin. So I'm just gonna spray it. It has very cooling sensation, very refreshing, and it is pure distilled rose water. Now let's move on to serum, and for serum, use a serum which actually works on your skin barrier, improves your skin barrier's health, because after your glycolic acid toner, your skin is exposed. So you need to improve the health of your skin barrier, okay? So for that, I will use the Cica and Ceramide serum today from Dr. Sheth. And Cica and Ceramides are very, very soothing. If you haven't seen the in-depth review of this serum, then please click on this link. So I'm just gonna apply this. This is cream based, but it's very lightweight. It does not make your face oily or sticky, and it gets absorbed into the skin, and it's very, very soothing. You can also use the Estée Lauder serum. It has similar function as the Cica and Ceramides. It also improves the skin health and improves the health of your skin barrier. So now we have done the toner serum, it's time for moisturizer. And for moisturizer, usually I use Plum Night Gel Moisturizer, Green Tea Night Gel Moisturizer, and it has glycolic acid. So today we are gonna skip it because we might over exfoliate. We need something more hydrating, more moisturizing, not exfoliating. So today I'm gonna use the Clinique Moisturizer, and I'm just gonna apply it on my skin. You can also use any sleeping mask that you use. Something which has hyaluronic acid, glycerin, all of these amazing hydrating ingredients, and deeply hydrate your skin, deeply nourish your skin. And when the next day you wake up and do your skincare routine, make sure you follow it up with your sunscreen. You can also use a Neutrogena Hydro Boost Gel Moisturizer, that one is also good and hydrating. And that's it for the skincare routine after your chemical peels. I hope I explained all of the confusion, because I've been getting a lot of questions regarding this. And also, I have both of these peels with me, the Ordinary Peeling Solution and Dot and Key Peel. The Dot and Key Peel actually is also very soothing and very gentle on your skin. I like to alternate both of these. Dr. Sheth is also approved by my extremely sensitive and acne prone skin type subscribers, so I feel more confident in recommending this one to you. And the Dot & Key Hydro Peel is little bit stronger than the Dr. Sheth, so if you are extremely sensitive skin type, then I recommend this. And if you want something stronger, then the Hydro Peel is for you. Now let's talk about the Ordinary Peeling Solution. This was my first peeling solution, and it actually irritated my skin and burned my skin, so I do not recommend this one. I feel that this is stronger than both of these together, so I do not recommend this using on your face, but you can use it on your elbows, on your knees, or somewhere you have texture or ingrown hair. So yeah. So that's it for today's video. I hope I answered all of your questions, and if you still have any doubts, please continue in the comment section. You know what to do, and I have mentioned all of these products in my description box. Bye.